Okay, so in this video, I'm going to show you how to create an email campaign within Dynamics 365 Marketing. So the first thing you want to do is go to your marketing app. And once this loads, you want to make sure you're under marketing here, which should be your default. But if not, you can just change it here. First thing you want to have is your segment created. This can actually be a second step. But if you want to do it first, you gotta have at least one segment created in order to send your email campaign. And if you don't have one, then I'm gonna show you how to create it. So keep in mind, you can create segments out of contacts and not out of leads. So in your CRM, whatever leads you have, these won't apply when we're trying to create the segment. Only contacts will. So in here, you get to select the options for a new segment. You can either choose a static or a dynamic segment. The static segment, what you're going to do in here is you're going to be adding people manually, and that's going to stay as it is. So if initially you add 5 or 100 or 1,000 people in there, that's how it's going to stay. And then if you choose the dynamic segment, then it's going to be updated as contacts match the options you're selecting here. So let's say you want to choose this template and you want to say, you know what, I want to create this segment based on this. You can select a message here. So these are some of the email campaigns we've sent out. So let's say I want to create a segment of people or leads we have that have clicked on this email. So I get to save it here. Or if I wanted to say, you know, I want people that clicked on, or leads that clicked on this email, but I also want to add this behavior block. And if they selected that email and also they clicked on this URL, then I want them here. So now that's your segmenting even more, right? So it's not just going to be people that clicked on this email campaign that you sent, but you also want to see maybe who took interest in it and who clicked on your links, and then you can add it here. So you can play with this here and segment as long as you'd like here. And then once you have this, it's going to ask you to save. So you're going to put a name to this, and then you're going to be able to see here. And we're going to have another video on how to create this. But as for now, let's just go with what we have here. So we're not going to save this one. So we have our segments here, and we can actually get to the marketing email. Let's actually go in here and create our marketing email. You can select here new, so you're always going to have that option, and then you're going to be prompted to this screen here where you can select a template or you can skip it, and you're going to have the white canvas here, so you can add from here the basic layout, and then elements like text, image, etc. I would like to go with a template, actually. So I'm going to be prompted here. And we do have a white paper that we want to send out. So I'm going to choose one of these. And I'm going to show you how to go from here. So let's say you want to delete any of these blocks here. You can. You simply click on it and then you delete it here. In here we have an image, so I want to add our logo here. These images are from previous email campaigns that we've sent out, so that's why they're already here in the media folder. But you can always just upload here and upload it from your computer. So any image will do. Here's our logo. I can change the size here so it looks good. And then I have it here ready. This is the white paper that we worked on and that we want to send out to our leads that are wanting to know more about Dynamics. So what I can do here is I can change the title. And I'll kind of speed it up here so you don't have to see me typing. So in here, again, you can change that image. If you wanted to delete it, you could here. As for me, I'm just going to change it because I have another one I'd like to use. It's going to be this one here. And then let's say this is done here. You can add more text if you wanted to. Again, you can do it here. Just select text and then it's going to ask you where you want it. Let's say it's here. Or you can add it from here. If you wanted to, it's going to be the same. I'll just delete it. Let's say this is done and then you just want to add a button here that says read more. And then you want to add a link. So you're going to be able to do it here on the right side. We do actually have it. In here. So we're gonna add the link here so that when our leads receive it, they can click on this and they're gonna be redirected to this link in our website. And then they're gonna be able to download it here if they want to, or they can just go through it here in our website. So this would be how you create it. This would be a basic layout and you can change this here. Again, you can, let's say you don't have, like for us, we wouldn't include this one. You can delete it. If you wanted to add one, then you can go in here and also add the image and make it fit in here. And then you can add in here, you can add the links. So for your LinkedIn, you would add it in here. So when people click on it, they can be redirected to your page. So let's just save this one here. Boost productivity. Workers with Dynamics 365. So this here, you're required to do it, and it'll also help you later when you're trying to find it, when you have more than one email campaign, then that's going to be easier. And you can also choose this arrow here and just copy paste the same, because if not, this is how it's going to show right now in your list. It's going to show up as email TW9. So it's just easier if you do this here. You change it, change the name, you save it, and now it's showing. So it's saved. There's a few things you can do in here. You can check for errors just in case you have any, and this will let you know. You can also test send. Before that, you can actually see here the preview, and then it'll show you how it's going to show in, how it's going to look in your different devices and in the inbox preview. So this is how it would look on a tablet. This is a tablet on vertical. This is going to be your mobile, and this is going to be desktop. And